What's up, guys? LQ here, we are halfway through 2023, and I've already put out my list of my top 10 favorite movies of the year so far in 2023. But now I'm looking ahead. I'm looking forward. We're halfway through the year. We have 6 months left in the year. I'm looking forward into what is coming out the rest of this year that I'm most anticipating. What movies am I most looking forward to? So I created a top 10 list, ranked them from 10 to 1, 1 being the one that I'm most looking forward to, and I'm going to share that list with you. So these are the 10 movies that I'm most looking forward to on the back half of 2023. But before I share that list, I thought I would give you five honorable mentions that did not make my top 10. These five are in no particular order, but first you've got Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom. Didn't make my top 10. I'm feeling less enthusiasm for the DCEU, even though I did like Flash quite a bit. Just the fact that the DCEU is coming to an end, and I don't really know where Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom, whether it's part of the DCEU, whether it's going to be part of the new DCU, if it's just this in-between thing, I don't know. And that's really affecting my anticipation for it quite a bit. Hunger Games: The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes. I really like the original Hunger Games movies. Part two is my favorite by far. Catching Fire, by far my favorite. I think that's just a really good movie. But I like one. I like Mockingjay Part Two. I don't like Mockingjay Part One. I think it's a really dull, boring movie. But as a whole, I enjoy the Hunger Games. And I just don't know enough about this one. I haven't read the book. My wife read it, and she said that it's by far the weakest book out of all the Hunger Games books. So I don't know. I'm gonna take her word for it. But at the same time, I am looking forward to this just because I do like the other Hunger Games movies as a whole. Next honorable mention is Meg 2, The Trench. I'm a sucker for shark movies. Anybody that's been around my channel for a while knows that. And the first Meg movie wasn't really good, but it was fun. I had fun watching. It's a popcorn movie. So looking forward to seeing what they do with the Meg 2. The next honorable mention is Joyride. I've heard nothing but positive things about this. Everybody that I've talked to, or any YouTubers that I've listened to who have seen this movie in advance, everybody raves about this thing. So it's just the positive buzz that has me looking forward to this so much. And the fifth and final honorable mention is Kraven the Hunter. I like the Venom movies. I don't think they're great, but I do enjoy both of them. I think that Sony is very hit and miss when it comes to its Spider-Man universe movies. Exhibit A, Morbius. But I don't know. I'm a fan of this universe, and I want to see what they do with Kraven the Hunter. All right, so let's get into my 10. In 10th place, we have The Marvels. Listen, I've been mostly disappointed with the MCU since Endgame. There's been some gold in there for sure. Spider-Man No Way Home, the WandaVision, there's definitely been some gold in there, but there's been way more turds than gold. It has been most Phase 4 is mostly a huge letdown for me. I really felt that Marvel just kind of lost its way during Phase 4. And Phase 5 has not gone off to a bang yet. Quantumania was not very good. But that being said, I do think that Ms. Marvel, while it wasn't really my cup of tea, I think it is one of the stronger of the Disney Plus Marvel shows, just from a narrative standpoint, just from the story that they was choosing to tell in that series. Rambo, she was a standout in WandaVision, and I really liked WandaVision. And then obviously Captain Marvel. I didn't hate her movie, but I didn't love it. But bringing those three together looks like it could be a fun concept, the way that they switch places with their powers. I'm hoping. I'm hopeful. I'm always hopeful that Marvel's going to turn in a good movie. So The Marvels is number 10. Number nine is honestly probably in a lot of people's top three. It might even be in a lot of people's number one that they're looking forward to in the last 6 months. And that's Dune Part Two. I'm definitely looking forward to it. It's in my top 10 that I'm looking forward to the rest of the year. But a couple things kept it from being higher on this list. Number one, I'm not a huge fan of the Dune book. Now, granted, it's been a few years since I've read it, but I have read it, and I wasn't a huge fan of it. It didn't speak to me like it speaks to a lot of people. And number two, the first movie, I didn't love it. It didn't do a whole lot to make me super excited about part two. I found it a little visually dull, and I know that's crazy. The special effects are great. There was not a ton of action in that movie, but there was just enough that you would have thought that visually I would have been more excited about it. But for whatever reason, film is our artist subjective, and for whatever reason, Dune 1 just kind of left me feeling a little blah on it. I'm looking forward to it. It's my number 9, but I'm having a hard time getting more excited about it. So, Dune Part 2 is number 9. All right, number 8. Number 8 is The Expendables Part 4. What can I say? I'm a fan of 80s action heroes. I'm a fan of the first three Expendables movies. Yes, even three. Part 3 was by far the weakest of the franchise. I still had fun with it. I don't know. I'm looking forward to it. Sue me. I love Stallone. I love Statham. This should be fun. It should be disposable popcorn fun, which, it's perfectly fine to go to movies for disposable popcorn fun. And that's what this looks like. All right, number seven. Number seven is Rebel Moon. I'm a big Zack Snyder fan. I love Zack Snyder. Man of Steel is one of my favorite comic book movies of all time. Zack Snyder's Justice League was great. You look at 300. 300 was amazing. You look at Dawn of the Dead. He has done some excellent Watchmen. He's done some excellent genre storytelling. Even his bad movies like Sucker Punch. Sucker Punch was a terrible movie, but visually it was appealing. So even his bad movies have that certain flair that Zack Snyder's known for. Rebel Moon looks like, I haven't seen much of it, but from what I have seen in the still photos, it looks like it's got a certain kind of Zack Snyder flair that I'm gonna definitely have a good time with. But more than that, I just enjoy Zack Snyder's style. Even Batman v Superman, I just enjoy the style. So, Rebel Moon is number seven. Number six is Oppenheimer. I know a ton of people who think that Christopher Nolan is like the next Steven Spielberg. I don't really put Christopher Nolan on that high of a pedestal. I love the Dark Knight trilogy. There's definitely some other Nolan movies that I really enjoy, Dunkirk being one of them. I really like Dunkirk. But I honestly find a lot of Nolan's movies to be very enthralling and gripping while you're watching it, but I don't find the rewatchability factor in Nolan movies to be extremely high. I remember everybody was just raving about Interstellar, and I finally went to the theaters to see Interstellar near the end of its theatrical run, and I was like, all right, it was a good movie. I still haven't seen Interstellar again since I saw it in theaters. He's a great storyteller, Christopher Nolan. He is a great storyteller. I'm just not as into his type of storytelling as a lot of people are. Inception, another one. I saw it. I liked it. I haven't seen it since I saw it in theaters. So I don't know. Just I haven't found his movies to be extremely rewatchable. That being said, I'm a history teacher, history buff. I love history, and this is one of those moments in history that is just a very dark time in human history. Something that I think Christopher Nolan could really capture well. So we'll see. Oppenheimer's my number six. Number five is The Haunted Mansion. I'm a big Disney nerd. Anybody who knows me knows that I'm a big Disney nerd. I haven't loved anything about Disney the past few years. They've really been letting me down with their movies, the Marvel stuff, the Star Wars stuff, the theme parks, their animated stuff. They've really gotten into this rut. And I hope they can get out of it because I'm such a big fan of Disney, the company, the IPs that they own. And I'm hoping that the Haunted Mansion is the beginning of Disney crawling out of this creative gutter that they've been in. The Haunted Mansion is a fun ride. It's one of my favorite rides in Disney parks. And yeah, it looks like it's going to be an interesting take on this IP. I didn't love the Eddie Murphy version at all. I think I tried to convince myself that I liked it when I first saw it, but every time I watch it, I like it less and less and less. So I'm really hoping that this one brings, I'm hoping that this one brings the Haunted Mansion sensibility. Scary, but not really scary. Fun, but still a little scary. So I don't know. Haunted Mansion's number five for me. Number four is Blue Beetle. Yes, I know. The DCU, the DCEU, whatever the case, whatever you want to call it, it's in this really weird place right now. It's in this weird middle ground where it's ending, but it's gonna reboot. How connected are they? It's this really weird middle place that we're in. I'm basing this being so high. I think people are gonna see how high I put this and think I'm crazy. I'm putting this so high for a couple reasons. Number one, I love the actor who plays in Cobra Kai, who's playing the role of Jaime Reyes. Just a fun, up-and-coming actor. I think he's going to do some big things in his career. But more than anything, this is so high because I'm such a huge fan of the Blue Beetle. I've been a fan of the Blue Beetle since I was 8 years old. Now, it was Ted Kord back then. I was such a fan of the Ted Kord Blue Beetle. Blue Beetle and Booster Gold. Justice League International. Man, I had so much fun with Blue Beetle. And if I had my way, this would be a Ted Kord movie instead of a Jaime Reyes movie. I think Ted Kord might make an appearance in this. I don't know that for sure. But either way, I love Blue Beetle. Don't know. I've just been reading the Blue Beetle comics forever. So definitely looking forward to this one. Number three, my third most anticipated movie for the rest of this year is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles: Mutant Mayhem. I'm a big Blue Beetle fan. I'm an even bigger TMNT fan. Guys, TMNT was it for me growing up. I still have all the action figures. All of them. Like, I don't know if I'm missing any. I don't think I am. I have probably around 100 of them downstairs. Huge TMNT fan. The 1990 Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles is one of my top 10 favorite movies of all time. I even look at Secret of the Ooze, TMNT 3, Turtles in Time. I look at those three movies and I'm even like, yeah, sure. They were bad, but I like them. TMNT, the animated one. Turtles 2014, Turtles Out of the Shadows. I had fun with all of them. Even the giant hulking designs of those last two feature film movies. I love the Turtle movies. What can I say? I'm a fan. I'm a fan. Turtles Forever. Who hasn't, who, what Turtle fan hasn't seen Turtle Forever? Because if you're a Turtle fan and you haven't seen Turtles Forever, yeah, you gotta get out there and watch Turtles Forever. It's a great animated movie. Guys, I even have on VHS tape the Coming Out of Their Shells concert. That's where I'm at. That's the world I live in. All right, so TMNT Mutant Mayhem is number three. Number two is Mission Impossible Dead Reckoning Part One. Now, I have not been a huge fan of the Mission Impossible movies. I loved Fallout, though. Loved Fallout. I think Fallout was one of the best action movies that I've seen in the past decade. I would put it top 10 action movies in the past decade. Fallout was excellent. And it's funny because I think that every time a Mission Impossible movie comes out, I like the franchise even more. And it really hit that peak with me with Fallout. Hoping that Dead Reckoning Part 1 picks up where it ended with Fallout and just runs with it, keeps that momentum going, because I loved Fallout. All right, but my most anticipated movie for the rest of 2023, and it's probably nobody else's most anticipated movie at the face of this planet, but for me, it's Ghostbusters 4, the sequel to Ghostbusters Afterlife, guys. I'm a Ghostbusters nerd. I'm a Ghostbusters nerd. And Ghostbusters Afterlife did such a good job of capturing the essence of Ghostbusters, what Ghostbusters is. And, scary, funny, friendship, it did such a good job of capturing all that. It felt like Ghostbusters 3. Now, would I have rather seen a Ghostbusters 3 take place? Would I have rather seen them made one in the early 90s with the original Ghostbusters being Ghostbusters, playing in Ghostbusters 3? Yeah, probably. But you know what? That's fine. We didn't get that, but we did get Ghostbusters Afterlife, and it was a darn good movie. So I have high hopes that Ghostbusters 4 is gonna just run with that same momentum. Back in New York, Walter Peck is back, and just have some fun. I think Dan Aykroyd is back. We know Ernie Hudson is back. I assume Bill Murray is gonna at least film a cameo. But all the pieces from Afterlife, it looks like they're all gonna be here, and that's great because I loved Afterlife. So that, my friends, is the 10 movies that I'm most looking forward to for the rest of 2023. What movies are you most looking forward to? Let me know in the comments below. Maybe I missed something. Maybe you think my list is garbage. Maybe you agree with everything I said. Who knows? Let me know what you think in the comments below. Thanks, guys.